हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल केमिकल अड्डा। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन ड्राइंग अंडर कांस्टेंट ड्राइंग कंडीशंस। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द टाइम रिक्वायर्ड टू ड्राई मटीरियल अंडर कांस्टेंट ड्राइंग कंडीशन। बट बिफोर मूविंग इन टू दिस टॉपिक, इफ यू हैवंट वॉच्ड द प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑन ड्राइंग, मेक श्योर टू क्लिक द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स टू चेक दैट आउट फर्स्ट। It'll help you understand the basics before we move into this topic. And make sure to watch this video till the end. Now, first, let's understand what is given in the example. So, in the example, we are given that a wet solid is to be dried from 35% to 10% moisture under the constant drying conditions in 5 hours. Which means that we are given initial moisture content on the wet basis is equal to 35%. Final moisture content is equal to 10%. The time required for drying the solids from the initial moisture content of 35% to the final moisture content of 10% is equal to 5 hours. Then we are also given that the equilibrium moisture content is 4% and the critical moisture content is 14%. Hence, we are given equilibrium moisture content is equal to 4% and critical moisture content is equal to 14%. Then, in this example, we have to calculate how long it will take to dry solids to 6% moisture under the same conditions. In short, we are asked to calculate the time required to dry the material to 6% moisture content under the same drying conditions. Now, if you notice carefully, this example actually involves two cases. In the first case, we are told that a wet solid is dried from 35% to 10% moisture content and the drying time for this is given as 5 hours. This means that we already know how much time it takes to dry the material from 35% to 10% under constant drying conditions. And in the second case, we are given that a wet solid is to be dried from 35% to 6% moisture under the same drying condition as the first case. And for this case, we are asked to calculate the drying time. Alright, now let's move on and solve the example step by step. But, we are given the moisture contents on a wet basis, which is defined as the weight fraction of moisture in the total weight of the wet solid. Hence, let's denote XB the weight fraction of the moisture in the solids on a wet basis. Therefore, we get X1 is equal to weight fraction of initial moisture in solids, which is equal to 0.35. X2 is equal to weight fraction of final moisture in solids, which is equal to 0.10. X star is equal to weight fraction of equilibrium moisture in solids, which is equal to 0.04. And XC is equal to weight fraction of critical moisture in solids, which is equal to 0.14. Then, as we know that, drying usually occurs in two periods. First one is constant rate period, where moisture content drops from X1 to XC. And second one is falling rate period, where moisture content drops from XC to X2. But if you notice, in this example we are given, the drying time 5 hours is required to reduce from initial moisture content, that is X1 is equal to 0.35, to final moisture content, that is X2 is equal to 0.10. And if you look at the values of X1, X2 and XC, we can see that X2 is lower than the critical moisture XC. This means that after reaching the critical moisture of 14%, drying continues further in the falling rate period until it reaches 10% moisture. Therefore, we can say that the total drying time of 5 hours covers both stages. Hence, the total drying time of 5 hours includes time during the constant rate period, which is denoted by TC, and the time during the falling rate period, which is denoted by TF. Hence, we can write T, the time of drying is equal to TC plus TF, which is equal to 5 hours. Then, we know the formula for drying time for a constant rate period and falling rate period. Hence the formula for the time required for drying is T is equal to W dash divided by ARC into x1 minus xc plus w dash into xc minus x star divided by arc into ln of xc minus x star divided by x2 minus x star. Now, if we take w dash divided by arc common from both terms, we get t is equal to w dash divided by arc in bracket x1 minus xc plus xc minus x star into ln of xc minus x star divided by x2 minus x star, where rc is equal to the rate of drying in a constant rate period, a is equal to the area of the drying surface, w dash is equal to kilogram of dry solid, and capital X1, X2, Xc, and X star is the initial moisture, final moisture, critical moisture, and equilibrium moisture content on a dry basis respectively. Now, let's apply this formula for case 1, where wet solid is to be dried from 35% to 10% moisture, and for that drying time 5 hours is given. Hence we get T is equal to 5 hours. But in the formula, all moisture content is expressed on a dry basis, which is denoted by capital X, while the given moisture content is on a wet basis, which is denoted by small x. Hence for that, first let's calculate all the moisture content on a dry basis. So, first let's calculate capital X1. So formula is, capital X1 is equal to small x1 divided by 1 minus x1. As we know, small x1 is the initial moisture content on a wet basis, which we are already given as 0.35. So let's substitute the value of small x1 is equal to 0.35. Hence we get capital X1 is equal to 0.5385. Similarly, we can calculate capital X2, Xc, and X star. Hence we get capital X2 is equal to 0.111. Capital Xc is equal to 0.1628. And capital X star is equal to 0.0417. Now, let's substitute the values of T, X1, X2, Xc and X star in the formula. So, after substituting all values, we get, after solving this, we get the value of W dash divided by ARC is equal to 11.28. Now, let's apply the same formula for the second case, where we are given that a wet solid is to be dried from 35% to 6% moisture under the same drying condition as the first case, and for this case, we are asked to calculate drying time, which means that we have to calculate the T. So, we already have a value of W dash divided by ARC is equal to 11.28, which we calculate from case 1. Then we are given that the drying condition is the same for both cases, but the final moisture is different. Hence, for the second case, we can use the same value of X1, Xc, and X star. But, to calculate capital X2, we use same formula as case 1. Hence we can write X2 is equal to small x2 divided by 1 minus small x2, where small x2 is the final moisture content on wet basis, which is given as 0.06. So, after putting the value and solving it, we get capital X2 is equal to 0.19. Now, let's substitute the values of W dash by ARC, X1, X2, Xc, and X star in drying time formula. So, after substituting all values, we get, then, after solving this, we get T is equal to 6.56 hours. Hence, 6.56 hours will be required to dry material from 35% to 6% moisture content. So in this way, using a formula, we can easily determine the drying time. That's all for today's video. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Chemical Adda for more easy to understand explanations on mass transfer operations and other chemical engineering topics. Also, check the description box for notes and links to related videos, including our previous video on the basics of drying. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.